So cultural burning is really an approach to fire that's different from Western risk resilience framework, which is hazard reduction burning. So cultural fire really looks at the country, looks at the country type, understands what type of fire and when, and it comes from traditional knowledge, so a really deep understanding of place. Cultural fire is a way to kind of bring that landscape back into balance and I guess just restore the health of that landscape so that if you do get a bushfire through that area, it's not out of control, it's within control. It's already burning land that has had fire put through it, going through land that's really healthy. And actually what you might see is a wildfire, rather than scorching the landscape, actually is good for that landscape once it's in that balanced state. It's not something that's going to burn really quickly and really hot.
With the cultural burns, we do it in the cooler months of the year, which allows us to control the outcome and it doesn't scorch the ground. So we'll go out and we'll burn the grass trees and melaleucas, which in the perfect conditions burn really hot. So if it's a rainy day, we'll go out and candle them and it just burns the outside and doesn't cause harm to the trunk.
Indigenous-led conservation can really help provide the knowledge and guidance that we need to be able to create healthy habitats. You know, they were healthy for thousands of years, and by working closely and learning from our traditional owners and Indigenous partners, we can help bring that knowledge back on country and help us to recreate these healthy habitats that are so needed.
Core samples were taken from the 18-mile swamp over a number of years, and they could actually scientifically prove when the burns stopped and species took over where previously the burns would rid them. And it's something we've always known, that the traditional fire burning techniques did actually protect the environment from introduced species and regenerate growth.
So the best country to burn culturally is healthy country. Putting fire into healthy country means that you're going to get a really nice response from the fire. It'll be low, it'll be slow, it'll activate the minerals, it'll activate the trees, it'll activate the seeds that are in the soil, and the new growth that comes back will grow back really quickly. It'll be the right plants, the right quantity, the right variety for the area. And if you keep kind of managing it in that way, you end up with an area that's a lot less prone to bushfire. And even if one does come through, it'll burn more appropriately.